2020 has been an extraordinary and challenging year for almost everyone. The COVID-19 crisis has claimed over a million lives. After a modest dip in June, the outbreak has continued more or less unabated, with deaths running at around 40,000 a week. That's one every 15 seconds. The human impact has been dramatic, particularly in countries or states with weaker healthcare systems or whose response to the crisis was at best half-hearted or at worst flippant. In absolute terms, the United States has the worst record, and other countries such as the UK still have a huge healthcare mountain to climb. The economic cost has also been staggering. In the USA, new jobless claims reached an unprecedented 6 million in a single week. Even now, 27 weeks after that initial peak, jobless claims are still running at around 800,000 a week, four times the level seen before the crisis. In other words, employment is volatile, creating stress for many people and adding to the challenges of business and investment decision making. Around the world, the economic outlook remains incredibly uncertain too, as highlighted in the OECD's recent Economic Outlook report, which highlights that growth may be very slow to return. Against this background, the US presidential, Senate and House elections are now just 3 weeks away. There is no doubt that we are in unprecedented times. For the first time, a sitting US president has called into question the integrity of the electoral system over which he presides. For the first time, commentators have suggested that the US election might benefit from international independent supervision. For the first time, social media platforms have been forced to mark comments by senior political figures as misleading and to flag their posts as containing manipulated media. For the first time, journals such as Scientific American have endorsed one of the candidates for president, in its case breaking with over a century of tradition. As in 2016, and indeed 2012 and 2008 before that, the polls forecast a Democrat win by a solid margin. But the detail is much messier than that. There is significant volatility at a state level, and of course this is a race not just for the presidency, but also for the US Senate and the US House of Representatives. In the foreground, a process is also underway to appoint a new justice to the Supreme Court of the USA, just days before what is almost certainly the most contentious election in several generations. How can we make sense of all this? In Ballot Box, we will look at how the US presidential, Senate, and House races are shaping up, including how state-level dynamics, the COVID-19 crisis, and economic performance variations across the country may impact the result. We'll also explore the implications for business and investment decision-making, including what this might mean for cross-border business development, as well as ongoing investor and societal focus on the importance of sustainability and ESG. We'll also look more broadly at the rise of populist regimes around the world, their implications for governance, international trade, and society at large, and how the US election result may echo around the world. We're delighted to be joined by Kurt Lieberman from Magnite Global, and as always, the discussion will be live and interactive, so we're looking forward to your questions and contribution too. Please do share a link to this with your friends. You can just point them to live.esgx.org. And if you're watching on YouTube, then please do subscribe and use the like button. Finally, from me, Nigel Lake in New York, and my co-host Paul Herman in San Francisco, thank you to our ongoing sponsors Pottinger and Hip Investor, thanks to whom ESGX Live is free, open to all, and global. We very much look forward to your questions and to the discussion, and thank you very much for joining us.